everybody. This is Tina from Pasadena. I am in sunny Claremont. And if you don't know already, I am running for a delegate of the California Democratic Party again. So thank you all very much for voting for me 2 years ago. We're going to do this again. We got to keep pushing the Democratic Party on a progressive platform because we need to prepare for 2020 now. And I'm here with Mike Booz from Claremont. He's Hello. An activist and a musician. And we're at the farmer's market and we are interacting, engaging our constituency. So we are running on the Democrats for Justice slate. We have 14 candidates and 9 of us are former teachers, and so we are very pro public education, fully funding our public education. So we are united with UTLA strike. And a lot of us come, actually I just met Mike
like 4 weeks ago or so.
4 weeks ago, and because we share the same values, it was very easy to work together, and very easy to work together. Yep. So,
agreed.
Mike was a little bit unsure about running, but I think, you know, once you have the platform, that's all we care about. You know, I love that we are not career politicians. We are just ordinary folk trying to make a better future for my children, for, you know, our future, his children too. We both have two girls. So Mike, tell me about your experience and why you're running in this election.
Well, bottom line is you asked me. But, you know, when Pamela Casey Nagler asked me to come and join you and meet you, and I looked at the platform, she had shared it with me and asked me if I was in alignment with it. And I immediately was attracted to the many of the planks, in fact, all of the planks on the platform. And when I came down and talked to you and saw how passionate you were about these issues, and we kind of had a chance to get to know each other's backgrounds a little bit, I figured, well, what the heck, you know, I'd been, for the last 2 years, I'd really gotten more and more active in supporting Democratic candidates and walking precincts in California 39 and California 49, and ended up with positive results for Gil Cisneros and Mike Levin. That really energized me, and I was thinking, okay, well, now I got a little time off and it's the holidays, but all of a sudden I got approached about this, and it just seemed like the logical next step for me to get involved and to show that California is can lead the nation in showing the rest of us how this progressive platform can work, and you know the way forward for our nation and to save our democracy. And so, you know what? And when they say all politics is local, you know, this is a way for me to get involved in the grassroots. And you know, I've never run for anything before in my life. I haven't, and I clue.
And that's why I love Mike, because he's just doing it for the cause. Like, we don't care to. This is not a career. You know, we want is to make, you know, our community better. So I still have trouble. So 2 years ago, I was where you are, which is, what is this ADEM thing? And and we were, you know, I was part of the Bernie Sanders campaign, and that's, you know, Bernie kind of connected the dots for me. I was very much active in my daughter's public schools, and continually spiraling down, cutting the budget cuts, and parents were, you know, shouldering the burden of fundraising. And it's like as if every month there's a new fundraiser. So basically I took my activism from public education to politics, because really it is stemming from our political system and the corruption in the political system, the tax breaks that corporations get, that they should be paying their fair share of that money. We could be generating and giving back to our communities and to public schools and social services. None of that's coming back to us that we should have. So that's why I'm involved into politics. And I know this is not something like my mom friends, you know, feel comfortable with, but to me it is taking the next step. It's what grassroots can do through this delegate system. We can make a difference without, you know, leaving our full-time jobs or leaving our, you know, routine lives. This is something we can do that actually makes a political impact. So are there any issues that you feel most passionate about?
Well, funny you should ask. the issues on our the planks on our platform are all issues that are important to me. But I think at the headwaters of all this is finances and getting money out of politics.
What does that mean? Some people don't know what that means.
Well, big, you know, particularly big money. You know, when you have corporations and the wealthy able to through a variety of means donate large sums and unlimited sums of money into campaigns, inevitably even the best of politicians find they have to run for re-election, and if they don't raise money, they're not going to win.
And so we're talking about like healthcare, big pharma, fossil fuel.
These are concerns for the common good, for that, you know, like healthcare, for one. You know, to have healthcare, have the people that are in charge of the healthcare be a for-profit organization, means that their bottom line is making a profit. It's not about taking care of people per se.
Yeah,
now that's not
to
say that there aren't plenty of good people out there, and I'm not saying that, but I'm saying that there's so much money involved that when you're trying to make change, you're running into a wall of money. And you know, the common person, they talk about this is that money is free speech, or you know, corporations are people. But what happens is that it gets too expensive. Free speech is so expensive, nobody can afford it unless they're rich. And so when you try to advocate for these kinds of policies that are going to help all people, you run into so many impediments to the progress, because politicians are constantly required to raise money. And when they get money from somebody, of course, that's going to give them access. And so what's really important to me is if we could get at least the big money out of politics and just make small donations from the everyday person, then the politicians will have an opportunity to really serve their constituents. Their constituents will be the people who vote for them rather than the people who are donating large sums.
So I'd rather have, you know, we're running a campaign. We're running a campaign, and I'd rather have $5, you know, 20 people to donate $5 than to have one person donate $100, because when people donate, that's them investing in something, and that's them engaging, and that's them, you know, wanting to be involved. So the more small dollar donations, the more we can get people involved. I think that there is validity in, like, okay, yeah, we need to raise enough money to run a campaign, but it kind of becomes ridiculous when you got, you know, a huge donations to, it drowns out any other sort of grassroots candidates. Then no longer represented.
Yeah, and when you have candidates who have to spend half of their time raising money, mm-hmm. rather than doing the work that they were elected
they're
to
talking
do.
To their constituents, making, you know, going to town halls, maybe, you know, engaging with their constituents, actually knowing what their concerns are, you know, rather than being on the phone, you know, calling their big donors.
Yeah.
So
that's a really important issue, sort of at the top of my list, even though many of these other issues are really existential issues, things that are super important for us.
So at the top of the list is, you know, getting money out of politics, Medicare for all, Green New Deal, affordable housing, and rent control. Let's make that that distinction there. We support rent control, and I'm a renter.
Me too.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Uh-huh.
We have a few renters on our slate, and you know, in my city, Pasadena, over 50% of us are renters, and our city council and our mayor has made it clear that they do not support rent control. But we're continuing to push them, and you know, you can't be at the mercy of your landlord. Literally, my landlord can change my entire life by raising the rent. He could change the course of my daughter's life, because then she has to move schools and she will lose her entire world. So we must have rent control. It's not the main solution, but it's a start to kind of stop the bleeding of this housing crisis. Let's see. So let's talk about the election. So it's coming up in 6 days, Sunday, January 27th. It's in Claremont at a Union Hall. The address is here. You can go to our website. But there it is. You can go to adems.vote/8041 and get all the information. And yeah, we're going to get out the vote. We are utilizing all our skills from taking back the house. So this is, I am so inspired by the people I've met. I'm inspired by Mike. And we're at the farmer's market. And we were meeting people every day. And this is how it should be. This is how politics should be. It's simply connecting to as many people as possible and, you know, unifying behind an agenda that makes a difference in everybody's lives. So would you like to add anything else in the cover?
Well, I just think that there's the priorities in this country need to be to take care of the people that live here. And, you know, we're the wealthiest nation in the world. And there are so many other countries in the world that have far fewer resources than we do. They're not as wealthy as we are, that have figured a lot of this stuff out. And we can do this. We know in California, we had the master educational plan in the 60s. And when I started going to college in the early 70s, I went to junior college, I think 1974, 75. I went to junior college for about $13.
Wow.
Then I transferred to CSU, and that was about $90 a semester. So $180 and change per year. So it was an incredible opportunity, and we know we could do it. What happened was Proposition 13, and that had a big impact.
And guess what? Prop 13 reform is coming in 2020. It's going to be on the ballot. The Schools and Communities First Act. I'm very excited about this to close the corporate loophole on Prop 13. And just to support what Mike was saying, is my mother also went to college for free, tuition-free college at UC Berkeley, so back in the 60s. So I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for that. And when I'm talking to people, knocking on doors, and just at the farmer's market, I hear about these stories where people are just mired in debilitating debt. We can't move forward. We can't punish people for pursuing higher education. This is just backwards. This is not what America is about. Anything else?
Well, I think it applies also to healthcare, too. You know, that other countries have figured this out. There's no reason why people in this country should have to lose their home.
I'll take this home.
Because they get an illness, a long-term illness. And, we just have to come together and decide as a community and as a nation that we can take care of our own. And we have the resources. It's just, how do we do our books? Where who giving tax breaks to people who are already rich doesn't make sense when we have so many people that are suffering. And people are people, no matter what where they come from, and they deserve basic health care and education. And these are things that make
basic
our nation
needs.
Stronger.
These are basic needs.
Doesn't make sense to have the people that live within your community to have access to health care. So they can get a TB test and they can get preventative health care for pregnancy. These people are going to be healthier. And then if they're, and also they can be better educated. It just only makes sense.
Yeah, I mean, I put off going to the doctor because I don't want to pay that $20, copay. But with like a single payer system, Medicare for all, we don't have to do that anymore. We can get rid of insurance. We can get rid of that middleman. We can get rid of navigating the different insurance companies that you sign on to every time you change your job, or even doctor's offices, they have to be familiar with all these different systems. well, we need one system that handles all of this. It exists already, Medicare. And I believe we are ready for that. I mean, we have a, you know, PAC headed up by Pramila Jayapal. I mean, all of the presidential candidates are on board with Medicare for All. I think we are, the country is ready. I think it's the support for Medicare is something like over 60 or 70%.
Yeah, I'm not sure about it.
Across,
so it's definitely
even with Republicans. So overall, there's a majority support for Medicare. So we're ready. That's one of our top platforms. And I want to point out that the Democratic Party, the reason why I do this is the Democratic Party needs to be clear on what they stand for. I believe that we were not very good with that in 2016. We cannot afford to make that mistake again. We must be clear, and that's why we need to run. That's why we are running, ordinary people like us are running on a slate for delegate, because we want to ensure that the party is making a stand on issues that really affect people's lives economically, and not just talk. We're talking about policy changes backed, or stances backed by policy changes. So I hope you come out Sunday, January 27th for Assembly District 41. We will have the links below. There's also a Facebook to fundraise. All of this is grassroots, so your small dollar donations are going to be very helpful. And please bring a friend, because every vote matters. There's probably going to be a few hundred of us to voting, so your vote will be that much more impactful. Any final words?
Well, I just want to thank you, Tina, for all you do. People, you don't know Tina here, but she is such a hard worker and just always thinking about ways to move our country forward and to get our slate elected. So it's been a real pleasure to get to know you. And
we got
a week to go, and we can exhale. But hopefully we have a real positive result, and people that know us will come out and support us and let us do some good work when we go to the convention.
All right. Thanks, Mike.
Thank you
for your time. All right, guys. This is Tina from Pasadena. Keep fighting the good fight.